Now, question number 76 again came from nuclear chemistry and was for 4 marks. And if you look at the question is pretty factual. Like, it is saying magnitude of energy released per fission is of order 200 mega electron volt. Then in each fission, 1 thermal neutron is produced. The percentage of nuclei undergoing unsymmetrical fission is maximum. And for 235 uranium, right? This isotope. So this question is very factual. Now the reason why I'm doing this question is because I generally do not do factual questions because they do not have any concept. And but it was requested by someone, so that's why I'm doing it. And I think this will be the last question from the 2017 paper, because rest of the questions that are left that I haven't covered are mostly factual or theoretical. So there's not much of explanation that is required in those questions. But anyway, if you find some question tough, or you want to know the answer or the solution, the proper solution for this question, for any question from this CSIR net June 2017, then you can just comment in the comment box, and I definitely do a solution to that question. Okay, so coming on to this question. So it says that consider the following statements for fission of 235 uranium with thermal neutrons. Then these three statements are given: that the percentage of nuclei undergoing unsymmetrical fission is maximum. In each fission, 1 thermal neutron is produced, and magnitude of energy released per fission is of the order of 200 mega electron volt. Now, first of all, the reaction for uranium is given by one neutron. Okay. When it reacts with this uranium isotope 235, it gives 141 barium, okay, and 141 barium and 92 krypton and 3 neutrons. So first of all, the second statement that it gives only 1 neutron is incorrect. So we can say that that statement is incorrect, and the energy released for this reaction is basically equal to 202 mega electron volt, close to 202 mega electron volt. So that means our C statement is correct. Okay. So our B statement is false. That is only 1 neutron is produced, because like you can see in the reaction, 3 neutrons are getting produced. And the first statement says that the percentage of nuclei undergoing unsymmetrical fission is maximum. Now what I mean by unsymmetrical fission is, so for example, this is 235. It gains 1 neutron, so it becomes 236. Right? So the daughter nuclei that should be formed should be symmetrical. By what I mean by symmetrical is, for example, if we are saying, for example, in this case, if we say, okay, 2 neutrons are formed, okay, so then we have this 234 uranium 92 left. So this should be the daughter nuclei that are like formed in symmetrical fission should be of equal amount. So it should be something like, say, daughter nuclei D46, and then this divide 234 by half will give you 117. So it should be 2117 D46 nuclei that we should get. That is symmetrical fission. But over here, if you see, we get 141 barium and the other is 92 krypton. So that means that this is unsymmetrical fission. So the correct option in, so the correct answer in this statement is, so first of all, our A statement is correct, okay, and similarly our C statement is correct. So the correct answer becomes A and C, okay. And now coming on to, I just wanted to discuss one particular topic. So what the scientists said that earlier, that if a nucleus has a atomic mass, okay, of greater than 230, so if a nucleus has atomic mass greater than 230, then it has to undergo unsymmetrical fission. Okay, so starting with thorium, the unsymmetrical fission should start. Okay, but recently what has happened is, I think in 2011 I read a research paper which stated that 180 Hg, okay, should form on fission 290 zirconiums. Okay, but in fact it does not do so, and it actually forms, it rather splits into 180 Hg, rather splits into circa 100 ruthenium and 80 krypton. Okay, so that is what is happening. Now I just wanted to bring this topic up first because there has been a lot of Like there's a lot of research that is still left. Nobody is able to understand nuclear reactions even after 7 decades of its discovery, right? So there's a lot of scope, tremendous scope of research in nuclear chemistry, in nuclear science basically, not just nuclear chemistry. So I would advise you guys to, you know, definitely go for fields of nuclear science, because I'm not saying that the other fields are saturated, but already a lot of other people are working in those fields and there's a lot of competition, right? And the chance of making a good and substantial discovery in those fields is very less. But if you compare that to nuclear science is practiced by only a very few researchers across the globe, right? And so, and also there are very few institutions. So in India, there's one is HBNI, that is Homi Bhabha National Institute. And then one is Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC, right? BARC. So these have their entrance exams and their PhD programs. So if you clear GRF or if you clear the entrance exams for BARC, you need GATE basically. They have their own entrance exam as well as GATE. So if you apply for these institutions, I think you have a better chance of making a substantial progress in science and you know, getting a name for yourself. So I would advise you guys to, you know, like go for fields that are a little different than where the population is going. So everyone is going for organic, physical, material sciences. Yes, they are important, they are good, but I feel that nuclear science is of much more value than right now, at least, than these fields, right? So yes, that's about it. So anyway, just if there's any question from June 2017 paper that you would want to request me to put to solve, I will do it. And I'll be starting with the previous year papers, like for example maybe 2014 or 2015 or maybe the last year's paper. So stay tuned and do like and subscribe my video. Thank you.